Welcome back. So in the previous video, I have explained what topic models are, but I realized that this is all really very abstract. So I want to give you an example so you can see what kind of output you get, what it might look like. And of course, you then also have the lab to perform a topic model on the speeches data and get a better understanding there. I have to, just a pre-warning though, this is research that I did with a co-author, Alex Maturo from Dublin City University. But this is a sort of an older version of the research we did. This is a couple of years ago. We worked on a book chapter where we used some of this, but really this should be taken a little bit with a grain of salt. So this had not very strong results and not too interesting findings, but I just want to give you an idea what this text analysis might look like. So the speeches we have are basically Putin speeches. So the Kremlin website has an archive where all the main events, press releases, short notes on events that took place, speeches that took place, etc., of the Russian president are online and available. And secondly, for the period that Putin was prime minister, from 2008 to 2012, I mentioned this last week, there is also a website that has an archive for all the premiers, the prime ministers, speeches and events and broadcasts, etc. So for Putin, for the entire period from 2000 to more recently, I think it's 2016, we have downloaded all the speeches and are able to download this. So we end up with a fairly large data set. First, we do all the organization of the terms that we talked about 4 weeks ago when we started to talk about text analysis. We moved all the short words. We stemmed all the words so that verbs, etc., different conjugations all become the same. We removed very frequent or very rare words because they do not help separating topics and documents. We removed all the stop words. We removed very short texts. In this case, we decided to split all the speeches in paragraphs as opposed to individual speeches. So the documents we have, one document is one paragraph. But we removed the really tiny ones, right? If Putin just says, welcome everybody, and that's the end of the paragraph, and then he moves on to the next, we exclude that. In the end, we are left with over 30,000 paragraphs spread over 11,000 documents. The frequencies on about 3,000 terms. Yeah, so you have a very large corpus, a very large series of documents. Okay, so that is slightly outdated, I think, compared to the previous line. But so of these speeches, the minority are from the prime minister, the majority from the president. Yeah? And some of these speeches we could attribute to Putin, some to Medvedev, some are from the prime minister period, some are from the presidential period. Yeah. So we can look over time. The length of these speeches varies considerably from short ones to about 2,500. Most of them are a bit longer. And we also have different numbers amount of data over the time period. And it starts from when Putin becomes president at the very end of 1999. And it goes up to 2014-15. Now, this is really the main slide probably here to understand what topic modeling does. So remember that every document, in this case, every paragraph, will be associated with every topic, and every topic will be associated with every term. But the weights or the probabilities will differ. So one document might be strongly associated with topic 2 and topic 4, but weakly associated with all the other topics. Or a particular word might be strongly associated with topic 4 and 5, but weakly associated with all the other topics. By looking at how the documents are associated with the topics, we get some understanding of what it might be about. By looking at how the terms are associated with the topics, we can understand what the meaning might be of the topic. And so here, in this case, we extracted 40 topics. So although it's unsupervised and we leave it to the computer to identify the topics, there's one parameter that you always need to give. That is the number of topics you want to find. The computer cannot identify these. So here we did 40 topics over these 8,000 documents. So the first topic And these are in random order, they're not so much sorted. The words that are most strongly associated with this topic, remember that every word in the document, in across all the documents, is associated with every topic, just to a greater or less extent. But the ones that are strongly associated, the five most strongly associated with topic one, are defense, military forces, arms, and technician. So from this, we can guess that the topic one really refers to the military, to defense. Right? The third one, for example, is economists develop task social growth. So this has to do with economic development. The fourth one, company invest productions market project has something to do with business and economics. Yeah. Topic six, farms, earth, land, state council, rural, has to do with rural development, etc. Some topics will be more difficult to associate with anything, right? So negotiations, worker problems, meetings, affordable is much less clear. Vladimir Vinny's rescue, not clear how to associate that at all. Also not entirely clear why you have Vladimir twice, by the way. Stage, people, means in, I mean, it's solved. It's really not so clear what the topic is. So sometimes you find clear topics, other topics are gonna be much less clear. No, by the way, that this is not strictly speaking LDA. We use the correlated topic model, but it's a small variation. What is interesting is if you can visualize with underlying dimensions these different topics. So what we did here is we actually used PCA, which we discussed 2 weeks ago, to study this matrix of topics by words. So we have the two matrices. Right, we have the documents by topic and the topic by term, and we use the topic by term matrix and use this matrix as the input for a principal component analysis. And then after the principal component analysis, we visualize the first two components. So the first, the horizontal axis, shows the most separation between topics in terms of word usage. And the second axis, the vertical axis, shows the second most variation between the topics in terms of word usage, right? You might have to go back to the PCA lecture to see what this is about. And then we have colored them by broad topics. So the light green we consider to have to do mostly with military and international relations. The red ones we think have most to do with finance and economics. The blue ones have to do with very generic rhetoric that is not so clearly identified. And finally, the yellow ones have to do, in our view, with not so much the topic that the speech is about, but the type of speech, the type of vocation. Yeah, so you can see how the model separates these different topics. And then finally, the topics that are frequently used, that are often highly correlated with different documents, are in a bigger circle. And the ones that are rarely used, that are not so strongly associated with particular documents, they are smaller circles. Yeah, so you can see that the biggest topic actually has to do with simple, folk, identity, not so clear what he's talking about, or some vague rhetoric, yeah, some general concerns. These things just appear all the time in these languages. They're not very clear topics. But sometimes it's about very specific topics, gas in the Ukraine, or the Commonwealth of Independent States, or international security, or economic crisis, or the budget. Yeah, these things come up quite clearly in some of these topics and are clearly identifiable. So using principal component analysis on the output of the topic model can sometimes really help to visualize what this is about, what the topics are about. The second thing we might do to study this data is to look at it over time. So here we wanted to look at whether security or Ukraine, etc., whether these topics differ in their usage over time. Yeah, so the solid line is talking about security, defense, military complex, etc. And you can see that there was much more speech about that by Putin during the period that he was prime minister than during the period that he is president now. Or we can see that international security spiked around 2000, late 2009, and then became less prominent. So we can evaluate these things over time. Yeah. You can also see that the budget was more prominently present in these earlier speeches than in later speeches. Okay, so that gives you just an example of how we can look at these topics, how we can identify the different topics, how we can visualize them, and you will see more examples of this in the lab. So that really concludes the substantive material of this course. In the next section, I want to say a few very generic things about data analytics, data science, and social sciences, and then I want to briefly discuss the third project in the final assignment.